going? Today I'm here with a art journal page. This is my mini delusions journal. I started using it with at the first you saw my little mermaid as a Copic mermaid, using my Copics, not my Copics, my Mexbys. I don't have Copics. Sorry, my Mexby markers. And though I just flipped through quickly, and there's a couple of pages in there that I've used to wipe off when I was making my Dina Wakely acrylic tags, which I posted on my Facebook page, if you want to have a look at those. And these were just wiping off brushes and stencils and stuff. And this page, I really liked it. I don't know why. I just liked the way it looked. And I decided to do a little bit of image transfer on it. So that lady there I found on Pinterest. And I've printed her out on my inkjet printer. I've reversed the image because I wanted her to be the same as the original image, if you know what I mean. And so I reversed it in Photoshop, and then I've printed it out on inkjet printer, and then I've used some gel medium there and just pasted that down. And what I do is I put a little bit on the page, and then I put some on the actual image, and then I put it down. You have to let it dry for about an hour. So I come back after about an hour or two, and then I spray it with a little bit of water, and you just gently rub it off with your finger. You rub off that paper pulp on the back of the paper. I don't know what you call it. And what happened there was my iPhone decided it just didn't want to record anymore. So I rubbed off that whole paper off the image, and I done some stenciling with that stencil with the camera roll picture things, camera films. That's a bit silly. And so, yeah, and that part wasn't recorded, so I've come back, and that's where I'm at. Now, that is a Pringles lid off of Pringles, you know, Pringles chips. That's the lid off one of those containers, and I have like a heap of them in there. I love them, and they just make the best circles. So that's all I've done. I've just painted around the edge with my Dina Wakely night paint, and just put some circles down. It was that easy. This is a Susie Blue stamp set. I've had this one for a while, and I've never actually used this part of it. I've used the tree, but this one I just liked it, because I was going to draw that anyway. I was going to doodle that, but then I thought, no, I'm going to stamp it for something different. So I'm just stamping that with my night paint again, because I like the night paint. It's not as dark as black, but it's still dark. So it still adds that element. And as you can see, I have got it all over myself. It's all over my hands. It's everywhere. For some reason, I always seem to get it everywhere. No matter what paint I use, I manage to get it everywhere. And when I leave my craft room, it's always on my face somewhere. And I'm just so, I don't know. I'm just a little bit clumsy, I guess. And my daughter's taken over that gene, because she's the most clumsiest kid I know. So I'm just drying that off with my heat gun. I do stop and come back a fair bit in this video, because this was Sunday. I recorded this Sunday night, and I was in the middle of doing a roast lamb. So I was having to stop and check the lamb and get the potatoes and veggies on and all of that sort of stuff. So I was sort of doing this in between cooking as well. So multitasking, if I could speak English. And I can't. We all know I can't speak English. So that's just a little bit of book paper. I think it's dictionary paper that I've just ripped up just to add another element to the page. And that's some clear gesso. I don't know. No, that's not clear gesso. That's just my normal Liquitex gesso. And I'm just using a brayer to wipe over that, just to knock it back a little bit, because that stamp that I put on there and the circles, they were just too much for me, and I just wanted to knock it back a bit, and I wanted to let the paper, the book paper, the vintage book paper, sort of like, you know, go into the background a little bit more. So I'm just wiping it over just with a baby wipe, just to take a little bit of the gesso off around the bright colours, because I still wanted those colours to come through. So this is my new favourite stamp. I love this stamp. I picked it up the other day from Kayser Craft, and it's just awesome. It was only $8.50. So get one. I love it. It's my new favourite stamp. It sits on my desk now. I'll probably live there forever. And I love it. And that's just my archival black ink from Close to My Heart. So this is a Dina Wakely stamp, and I'm going to use that stamp that says "You Are Enough" because this picture was from an old Vogue magazine that I found on Pinterest, and so it was sort of like a modelling sort of thing, and I don't see myself as a model. I'm a little bit larger, and you know how it is. And I just was making this page to tell myself that, you know, I might not be model thin and beautiful, but I am enough. I am enough. So now I'm going to use that matte medium, and I'm going to put down my little stamped title there. And I stamped that on a piece of vellum and just ripped it. And then what you do is you get that gel medium and you paint over your transfer image, and that makes it so it won't flake off and it won't peel off, and it also just finishes it off and gives it that finished look, and you can see that it looks much darker now. So now just drying that off, because I'm going to have a bit of doodling. I'm going to do a little bit of doodling on my page with some of my black pens and my white pens, and most of my white pens are just crap, and I can't find a white pen that will work for me. I just can't find one. They're just, I don't know what it is, me and white pens, we don't mix. The white Sharpie paint pens and I don't like each other, so I tend to not go for them. So, and these are just some gel pens, or you know, black markers that I pick up a whole heap of them from Officeworks when I go there here in Australia. And it's just fun because, yeah, and I just doodle with them. And then I pull out my Stablo pencil, black pencil, and I just add some more doodling. So that's pretty much it from me today for Mixed Media Monday. So if you do like my videos, please subscribe below. Please leave me a comment. I love to hear feedback from people, and even if you want to just, you know, tell me that you like it, or if you want to learn about a technique, or there's something more you wanted to know, just let me know in the comments below. And please head over to my Facebook page as well and check out, because I post some little projects that I'm doing and stuff like that that I don't actually record. So that's pretty much it today from me. Just a little quick one. And thank you so much for watching. And this is page done, thumbs up, love heart, and my little magical fingers. Bye.